I will fight for you.
She has been there, it will be 2 years next Thursday. The majority of that time has been spent secluded, locked in a cell. Bethany is autistic. Her part of the spectrum means that she cannot cope with situations that cause her anxiety. When I visited Beth, I knelt down at a hatch in a door, 6 inches square, and I talked to my daughter through that hatch, the hatch they feed her through. That's the hardest thing I've ever had to do. And there's no need for it.
So some of the things they talked about is the fact that they're locking autistic children up, secluding them because they don't have these proper trained people there that know how to deal with an autistic child. So to deal with their outbursts, for example. So instead of trying to figure out the proper care, such as being outside or around animal therapy, they just lock them up and that's their way of dealing with it. It also costs about £15,000 a week. So these kids are being used as cash cows, one parent actually said.
And one thing that really I noted to me is Jeremy, whose daughter Bethany was locked away for nearly 2 years, said his only way of communicating with his daughter is through a 6-inch hole in which they feed her.
I'll reach my hands out in the dark and wait for.
I mean, it's pretty heartbreaking to hear from
it is, yeah.
Jeremy there, Bethany's father. You know, the NHS England has accepted it's got her care wrong. The Care Quality Commission said in May the system's not fit for purpose. The unit where she's in has acknowledged that they don't have the expertise to really look after her.
Yeah.
I mean, she's not a criminal. What is going on? And can you give any assurances to Bethany's father that she's going to be moved into somewhere much more suitable for her needs?
Yes. I've met Jeremy and I insisted on a serious incident review. A serious case review into Bethany's care, which I've received a couple of weeks ago, conditions. Because the thing
is. I just want to bring it back to Bethany.
Yeah.
I just want to bring it back to Bethany. Can you promise that she will be moved into somewhere more suitable for Christmas? And will you take this apology, this opportunity to apologise to her father for the situation that his daughter has found herself in?
Yes, of course. I apologise to Jeremy and, frankly, to Bethany for the things that have gone wrong in her care.
I saw Jeremy was about a little over a year ago after the committee hearing of the Joint Committee on Human Rights. They've now issued their report. His daughter Bethany is out of seclusion, but before that happened, things got a lot worse at an Acadia Healthcare facility when she was moved in May of this year.
Arcadia accepted Beth into one of their facilities that deals with personality disorders. Beth doesn't have a diagnosis of personality disorder. Beth is autistic. Arcadia should never have accepted the referral. Because they accepted such a poor referral, they secluded Bethany in a room that you've seen the video with the hatch. Beth, we had no contact. I could not hold a hand. We could not hug. They made her sit on the floor behind a line before they would open the door to feed her. Because Beth is autistic, for no other reason than Arcadia took a referral they should have refused. They saw the money, they saw the benefit to themselves far above any care and treatment for Beth.
This is their largest revenue source, the Priory Group, which they had acquired in 2016, and so after the hearing in which they clearly saw and knew about, what would you say to Reeve Wadd, their chairman, or Deborah Osteen, their new CEO, who oversees that operation? Are the leaders leading, and if not, how can you provoke them to do so?
Put yourselves in the situation of the families that you are abusing. Use some of your horrifically gained profits to go out and buy yourselves some humanity.
And what would you say to the families on the other side of the US who are dealing with similar issues in very
fight. Network, use social media, use the media, expose the horrors. Let's shut this down.